kid. Trip ready?
What's up, guys? We're in Dustin, LA, Louisiana. Making our way to Florida.
1,000 miles into the trip. 7,300.
Alright, guys, we're in Mississippi. How cute he is. Gideon. The queen says bed. Yum. Good meeting. High five, kid.
Oh, what a kid.
So smart.
What a kid.
And then John will be right here, but he's filming.
All right, see y'all in the morning.
Time moves fast, cruising these back roads. Don't slow down if you're towing a heavy load. Lean on you. You lean on me, we'll get where we're going easily. Get our wheels unstuck with a little bit of loving. Give you.
We're here at the Savage Race. I have 30 minutes till the start line.
30 minutes.
Got the dad watching the dude.
Oh yeah.
Smashing up bananas for him. Looking
getting
pretty
close.
Good. This is bottle. Oh yeah. The bottle's right there. All right, guys. Man, I wish somehow I could get videos of the race. Oh, where's a rabbit when you need one?
So keep on keeping on till the walls come down. Reaching higher till your feet don't touch the ground. Hear the power of grace flowing out your mouth.
With Jack, the photographer, right here. He's got John
Savage
in the back.
Florida.
Getting some pictures. He's an epic photographer. So, yeah, go hit him up. The race. So, John was the ultimate baby watcher.
We had a blast.
I had to give up my band at that obstacle, but I felt very strong. I glided through the rest of the obstacles before that. So, we're going to the next. All right, we got John getting pictures.
I think he's calling you back.
Oh, he's calling back me back. At it. Back picture. Here you go.
I wonder what would happen if you say you wanna say and let the words fall out. Honestly, I wanna see you be brave. What you wanna say and let the words fall out. Honestly,
leaving the race.
Yeah.
Quick stop. At a restaurant, El Mexico, make a dog pizza. I got such a good accent, guys. Mm. Oh, was he crying?
84 some taquitos.
Dude, this Savage shirt that I got, it's a large. It looks like a dress on me. Then, have fun.
We'll see you after dinner.
See you after dinner. From here, we're gonna go to St. George Island.
On the beach.
Turkey.
And palm trees.
How cute that little dog. Oh my goodness.
This is like a nice little dog.
Makes me have chickens. So yeah, St. George Beach. We're going to sleep over there. Probably learn how to surf. Quick bite to eat.
Beer.
Out in the wild.
Looks a little comfortable, man.
Looks really comfortable. Cause...
What time is it, buddy?
1 o'clock.
Found a cool, secluded spot on the beach. John's making some tuna right now. We found a gate, but you couldn't drive our van inside. Plus the sand was real deep, so it would get stuck. Anyway, so we did a couple. What do you think it was? A 3/4 of a mile? A mile? 3/4 of a mile?
Yeah.
Probably.
I mean, the whole lot was open.
So we're trying to figure out if we want to sleep here tonight or we have a reservation at a spot, but it's not by the beach where we wanted it.
Look at the map, that is.
Yeah. But well, guys, look at this. Isn't it awesome?
See all those trees way out there? See that square there?
Yeah.
Thank you.
they're bigger than his head.
Big as your head?
Good job.
There's a trail through the trees to a cliff where Carolina meets the sky. Oh, and there's a view I just can't describe. No, we're not there yet, just a few more steps, baby.
Guys, we're out here in nature listening to beautiful sounds.
So nice.
I'm just jogging my way.
Yeah, imagine.
Your girl found her waterfall. There's no
water falling.
It's right there. 74 feet, I think is what it said. I thought it said 100. Well, it's like a deep, dark cave down there. We're in Florida still. So we stopped at Blackwater. I guess the water's black. State Park. It's a 17-mile. I don't think it's a loop. I think it's like a... We're going to do like 4 miles. 4 miles. Drive. Do another 4 miles. I mean, it makes the trip home a lot more fun because it's like you're real tired and then you get in the van and you drive or sit. Maybe I'll go the safe route.
Yes, I have him climb whenever I'm hanging out. I put him against it and he always climbs up to the orange one.
And he's climbing up a belt?
A wall of belts. Different belts.
Uh-huh. He did that.
18 miles, knock it out.
We have the Grid Ultra coming up. Go sign up. I'll put it right there. Volunteer here. I wonder if you get free passes.
Gotta fuel up.
Oh, I forgot Scar's seat.
Oh.
I'm sure he'd be fine in this thing. Not. Alright, let's go get our car seat. That any faster than that. And then we also saw a really cool train track that, like, I don't know if John did it, but somehow it got twisted.
Oh, yeah.
Someone pushed it. So I'll show you that
it's
if we get
floating
to
floating in the middle of the river.
Literally. What would be really cool is if we could find a lighthouse, an abandoned lighthouse that's like a mile out into the water. I'll climb up it. That'd be really cool. That's one of my goals in life, is to find an abandoned lighthouse that no one's been to.
Same.
Well, someone's been to because they have to build it. But like
historic.
Also, check out this cool shirt I got. Thanks, Savage.
The way your fingers fit in mine is 5 plus 5, not a rocket science. This day and time, that's hard to find, it's true. The road we're on ain't a traffic jam. It's a sunny drive on a piece of land. It's paradise as long as I'm with you. It's like 1, 2, 3, just as easy as can be. Just the way you look at me, make me smile.
We found a cool train track in here. This is me assuming that four-wheel drive in tech. Alright, the backwards talk. Following you. So, we keep trying to do 4 miles, but we keep coming into really cool things.
Don't.
Okay, guys, mile zero. This trail is confusing the heck out of me. I'm gonna go look at it. Look at this. I'm not mile zero. Dude, we are cruising down the path. 1 mile, you need that water, man.
Hey, nope, I'm good.
4 miles complete. Then we're gonna drive for a few hours and hit another trail. Try to find one a little bit more in nature and not so close to a library or Whataburger. Whataburger was right across the street. I meant to film that, but it was kind of funny. That's the van right there.
Nice though.
Yeah, I think it's 59.
Yeah.
59 degrees. When did we get in Mississippi? The Welcome Center. Okay. Yeah, so we're stopping every 1 to 3 hours. What a pretty dog. 1 to 3 hours, jumping out, running 4 miles, getting back in the car, just going along. I'm on that Find Trails app, and I just find a random trail that's close to a river, because that's how we take showers when you're living the van life right now. So we jump in the river, get back in the car, repeat until we get home. So we are currently 9 hours away from Texas, or 9 hours away from our house. I was talking to one of my friends and she said, I'm so glad that you found John, because not many people want to do what they're doing. Guys, it's so much fun. You just run like 16 miles on your way home. Also, this hoodie's for sale for $175. Storm just kicked in, so it's getting real dark, starting to rain. John just ran to go take a dip on the beach real quick. I think the degrees are dropping just a little bit too. So we're gonna probably go up north and find where there's no rain and a little bit of sunshine, except it's like 4 or 5, so we may have to just start again in the morning on the way back. I don't know if you can see him, he's right here. We'll see his update. Maybe. Whoa, that water was cold.
Yeah. It's awesome.
No dirt.
The water's kind of warm, actually.
That's nice.
Yeah.
Heat up my body. The sand feels really good. Is that a wishing well? It came upon us really fast. So. Alright guys, little update. We drove north kind of out of the storm until we found a nice park that we're at, Perry Clint Park. So we were gonna take I-10, which takes us all the way back home. But like I said, we didn't wanna drive through the night through all the rain. So we hit 59 or 55 going up north until we got out of the storm or whatever that was coming. So now it's nice and, wait, I guess it did rain. It's all, yeah, it's all wet.
Oh, yeah.
I guess we just missed it. So, yeah, no winds, no rain, comfortable here. Now we're literally in the middle of, I have a flashlight, but let me turn it off. Did a 360, that's the van. But, yeah, we're in the middle of the woods right now. Guys, we're at Perry Clint Park right now. Looking at the lake. Okay, zooming in. Isn't that cool? It's pretty, pretty, man. Back to the van, get our coffee that we don't have, get our breakfast that we don't have, hit the road, and find another state park.
And lesson number one, always listen to Buck. If it yes. wasn't for Buck, we wouldn't be here.
One big awesome S and spot. One big happy thing, hmm? And I think we've hit like 1, 2, 3, 4 state parks so far.
Something like that, I don't know.
That's only 4. We still have like 10 hours home because we went north and added, which is fun because he has to be back for work in like 2 days. So it's all good. But let me show you all the views. Also, we're not trying to confuse you because you're probably thinking, is it cold or is it hot? It's probably in the 50s, right? It seems colder than it was yesterday. But he's in, oh, you're not in long pants.
I brought this nice lime green hoodie to wear, and then I couldn't find it, so.
Nice talking to you guys. Who just cut a random pine tree? That poor tree. Rest in peace. So I stuck my toe on this big root. It's so cool. You probably can't really see it. Oh, let me get down. Alright guys, we found the next park. Clark something park trail. This is awesome in Mississippi. It's like steep on either side. Man, this is cool. So we may be doing a very slow 4 miles. Like, slow.
Waterfall we found. I don't know how to do this.
There's a Found it. Woo! I'll take the glorious tip to add 10 years to your life. I'm gonna make all y'all crave water. All right, we're gonna finish this. Run, baby. So John was thinking we should just make this our home. It's like a little cave with the perfect sound machine at home. This is what I put on every night with whales. Guys, I think I know where I'm gonna have my next baby.
Travel all across this land, me and you. And we'll end up hand in hand, somewhere down on the sand, just me and you.
Alright, we just found a really cool trail, so we're gonna hit that. I think I've paused my watch at least, 20 times? We were supposed to do like a solid consecutive 4 miles. But when you're on the scenic route, it's hard to do that. That is actually really relaxing. Now we're going to go drive another probably. We may stop in the Mississippi River because John showered in the waterfall. I didn't because I didn't want to get my hair wet because it takes about 2 hours to comb when it hasn't been combed. It hasn't been combed before that because you just keep going and running races and you don't stop. So I may plunge in there. Wait, it is sprinkling a little bit. But I'm pretty sure it's only for like a couple hours. We're going to go 20 to avoid all the storms and stuff, but we're going back to 10. Oh, check out this where I make all the food. Table right here. So yeah. Also, I think my nails grew a lot faster on this trip for some reason. It's just a random fact that came to my head. Guys, I haven't updated you in a while, but we're gonna almost drive all the way home, but it's 4.5 hours away and it's almost 8 maybe, and we're both tired, so we decided to stop at another state park, which is Village State Park here in Lumberton, Texas. Good night, fam. Thank you for watching this far, if you're still watching.
Gideon agrees.
That's cool. What? That's like a heater.
Oh, right.
Literally. There's this old couple. Golly. Spiders like me today. Except that's a fly. There's this old couple right by us fighting. You know they're actually laughing, though. It turns out. But they're pretty funny. It's like, I think they're playing checkers or chess or something.
Sounds good.
Good morning, guys. Someone's really playful this morning. I think Waffles are here. Goodbye. Got the fuel, man. We are in Houston right now. We are almost home. Stopping for breakfast right now at John's favorite spot. Newest thing right now is I'm looking for a woman to do Hyrox doubles with me. So if you're watching this, actually, it'll be like way after that. Here, can you hold it? So, wait, I think we're like 3.5 hours away from the house.
Yeah, not bad at all.
No. Look both ways before crossing the street. Yeah, hi, buddy. Been a great trip, guys. Very, very, very good. Dude, I haven't been to this place in a while. Like, the last time, my family, they were going to adopt a little baby. And it ended up going through. But this is where we met the person. All right, what tour do you want, dude?
He looked at the camera and then smiled.
Guys, last stop of the drive. We're gonna get some raw milk from the farm. I need cash. More cash. She said $8 a gallon. Betcha, I'm gonna make y'all be craving milk right now. shout out to Strix Jersey Farm.
So we could have gotten Unimas.
He's so cute.
We're stretched to get home. We got really tired, so we're here in New Braunfels to kick in a run. Get in a run real quick. We signed up for a race last minute, like 2 hours ago at High Rocks. So,
3 days.
Real quick, so we're good in the tack for that. So,
yeah, got to put in all that training.
But we found this abandoned track with all these people.
Yeah, I don't know what they're doing. It's abandoned.
Cheers, Mike. We're gonna do some 0.65 runs because, you know, train harder, so you gotta get that 0.03.
Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. It's the first of probably many. We just made it home probably 45 minutes ago.
2,700 miles.
Is that what it was?
Mm-hmm.
He's tired. I'm not really that tired. I was at the track. It hit me, but now I'm like better. I don't know.
You got your...
I got my tuna fish in.
You got your seventh.
Did you eat your tuna? All right, guys. See you on the next one. Mm.